Let's now get an update on the situation in Batangas. We now have on the line Governor Hermilando Mandanas. Governor, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron.
Governor, how are you? How are the residents of Batangas, and what's the situation there right now?
Well, of course, we have tension. Everybody is under stress. Mm-hmm. But in addition to our preparation, we have we have been all praying, including all the because this is the kind of situation we're in. Although we have we're in preparation, it's not enough. We have started our preparation way back with the help of PhilBox, that we have really been in coordination with them. We have called already before all our our calamity mitigation council, and at the same time we have constructed our evacuation centers, even in Balete, our housing for those whom we have evacuated. The schools were already closed, and that's the reason why when the volcano was on level 2 and level 3, there was already nobody there.
Mm-hmm.
And all and the evacuation around were already cleared. I was in Balete yesterday personally and calling for the members of the council, disaster risk mitigation, and we evaluated, and this morning with our Sangguniang already passed the resolution that we should really declare a state of calamity, and that way we will be able to augment our inventory of goods and food and relief materials. Also, our engineering is being for the clearing augmented by assets from the armed forces, from maritime, PNP, and of course for peace and order, our PNP personnel are with us too. The Red Cross, to Senator Dick Gordon, is also assisting, and the Department of Social Welfare, from day one, they have already been there, working with our own provincial. This was part of the organization, and even the non-government organizations are all coordinated right now. I made rounds earlier of the different of the evacuation centers just to make sure that food would be there and relief goods. And in Batangas City, you have the towns close, like Agonsi, close to the volcano. They have reached already Batangas City, and as far as Nasugbu, and on the northeast, Santo Tomas. So, we're only in level 4. We will have real problems when it reaches level 5.
Right.
We haven't reached that one yet.
Mm-hmm. Let's highlight what you said earlier, Mr. Governor, that you have been moving, and some activities have been done since the alert level was raised to level 2. That was last year, if I'm not mistaken. Is that correct?
No. Level 2 was raised only yesterday.
Oh, yesterday. Okay. Alert level 2.
Level 1
yesterday,
before.
Yeah. Alert level 1 before.
That was like almost a year.
Right.
We have, for sure less than, not less than 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
But even before that, it has been our program since past 3 years, and even before. And we are very fortunate that PhilBox really has a lot of installations here and warning signals. And they have been doing their job well, and we have been informed. And of course, we have to react. We have encountered difficulties, like people do not want to leave. And all that, but we just had to insist. We had to, I had to order stop all those schools that are in the island. They had to be discontinued and prohibited already the teachers to go there.
Mm-hmm.
And for those who were there for a while, we were like giving them boats. And right now the towns, we have provided them already since a year with speed boats. Big speed boats, capacity of 30 persons at least. So the town of Talisay, the town of Agoncillo, San Nicolas, so they were provided already. And the same we provided Maritime, PNP Maritime, and the Coast Guard, which right now they are with carriages, so they could easily be transferred.
Speaking
and
of...
in our budget, and in our budget for this year, we have probably will the first province that have already budgeted, approved, and got the funding to give one rescue vehicle for every barangay, which serves also as an ambulance, a rescue vehicle in times like this. And at the same time, we have now already canvassing, because of the orders, of all the medical equipment that would be really needed, not only in case of emergency like this, but for really general use, anticipating, as was approved, the universal health care law. So we have been doing this, of course, without media coverage, because this kind of activities cannot be done just when a disaster comes. It really has to be done years before, and because we have to follow rules and regulation and procurement and all of those.
Mr. Governor, so would you have the numbers on the number of people who were evacuated and their situations situation right now?
Well, we have already close to 25,000 persons, but this is mounting, continuing. We started with only like 3,000 yesterday, and then as we reach in the afternoon, and then it went as high immediately as 16,000 by the end of by this midnight, and then now it's already 25,000 and it's still increasing, because the tremor reaches up to here. I am in the capital, in Batangas City, in the capital city of the province, which is like 30 kilometers away. And the tremor is strong up to here. Of course, the light, and here in Batangas City, I've already talked and met some who were injured, but need not have any hospital treatment. I met at least five of them. A couple, for example, they were in a house, but because of the ash fall, the weight of the accumulated ash fall made heavier by rain, the roof collapsed. Right. So we are providing that for that too. So fortunately, they were only hurt a little bit, and which we are attending to them right now. But no need to go to the hospital. What we are confirming in terms is, again, news which we not yet confirmed, that the vehicle fell into a ravine, and there were 22, including driver, persons in the vehicle. But we couldn't confirm, because that happened supposedly last night. And because of that, we couldn't be confirmed. The Philippine National Police couldn't reach the place. The visibility is bad. The roads are bad. So there is no confirmation on that one, although we have received information. But so there are issues like those that we're trying to get not only the media, but even those on social media, that to be very, very careful in providing information. And likewise, we are making sure that everything is confirmed, because we do not want to create more tension and stress than what we already have right now. But we are really grateful that we were able to make all the necessary preparations to the extent that we could. And we also appreciate very much the help, starting from the President through Executive Secretary Miguel Dea, already coordinated. That's why we already have all the assistance that we're getting right now. Some are still on the way.
That's good to know. That's good to know, sir.
Secretary, Cabinet Secretary Carlo, Nograles likewise. But of course, the number one, as I said, who came on the national government was the Department of Social Welfare. But Secretary herself was here, and we appreciate that. They're in Talisay yesterday.
Mr. Governor, we are, the province is under alert level four. What are the activities and preparations the provincial government is doing for that possible hazardous eruption?
It's not only the provincial government. I would just like to stress, because the first responders, of course, are the municipalities. They have also their own budget. They have their own organization, except that they are coordinated with the province. So, as I said, the preparation for alert level 5, even, we have been doing this already since before. This means from the point of view not only of food and relief, but very especially the evacuation, and then also for those who hopefully will not be injured, but will be injured, our hospitals, not only the government hospitals, but even the private hospitals, not only primary or secondary, but even the tertiary health care. I was talking with the chief of hospitals. That's what we have been doing here right now.
Batangas Governor Hermilando Mandanas, thank you very much for talking to us.
If I may give you
go ahead, sir.
The number our head of our department on disaster risk reduction management office, we have already elevated. I think we're the only province that has elevated this particular function, necessary function, risk reduction management into a whole department with a whole department head, staff, assets, his name is Lito Castro. And this number, just so that you could get all the other, just in case there are other questions.
Okay, Mr. Governor, our coordinator will be getting the number of Mr. Lito Castro from you off air so that we may be able to call him and ask for more updates. But for the meantime, thank you very much, sir, for talking to us. We understand, of course, you're busy there taking care of the residents of Batangas, but we wish you well, and thank you very much for giving us the latest information from Batangas, sir.